I can still see the patient, I can still see my anesthesiologist, but I can now add these holograms into my environment.
We give her an idea of how the electrical signal travels across the surface of the heart. And by giving her understanding of what pathway it takes, then she can target the exact right spot to stop the arrhythmia. We give them real-time information of where the tools that she's put in the heart are and the map of where that electrical signal's traveling and how it changes once she makes a lesion or she destroys some of the tissue that's causing the problems. And we do that by connecting it to a system known as an electrical anatomic mapping system. And those have been around for a while, but everybody's been looking at that data on two-dimensional screens. They haven't had it right in front of it in 3D where they can control it and turn it left and right and up and down, and even just kind of move their head around the corner to see another side of it in a very intuitive way.
And what's even cooler is that you're able to make the model extraordinarily big and you can stand inside it and look around. It was the first for me when I did that.
We had physicians do it with the HoloLens and then using the 2D map. And we were really surprised to see that they were substantially more accurate once they had a 3D representation. It wasn't just a gimmick or something that was cool. It actually let them get to where they want to go more accurately.